The response from Brussels was a far cry from the fiery rhetoric so often used by the U.S. president, and some have even questioned if it was actually strong enough. In a joint statement, the Commission and Council presidents said, quote, the European Union disapproves of the fact that the U.S. decision to impose a travel ban was taken unilaterally and without consultation. But Mr. Trump was far more accusatory when he made the shock announcement on Wednesday night. During that televised address from the Oval Office, he placed the blame at Europe's doorstep, saying that it had failed to take the same actions as the U.S. did when it halted travel from China, and that now, as a result, a large number of new clusters in the United States were seeded by travelers from Europe. Mr. Trump also said that all goods would be included in this ban, but the White House quickly corrected that mistake. The restrictions will not apply to cargo. But to say the very least, this announcement has taken many here in Brussels by surprise. In a tweet this morning, Council President Charles Michel said European officials needed to assess the situation and that economic disruption must be avoided. But there is little hope that that can actually happen because this travel ban will be in place for 30 days, which is a significant period of time for businesses. And Europe is already grappling with the economic repercussions of this outbreak. It's losing at least €1 billion every single month in tourism receipts. A number of European airlines are in near collapse. And consumers are avoiding, and in some places they've been outright banned from going to shops and restaurants. And there are growing concerns that COVID-19 will tip, at the very least, Germany and Italy into recession and perhaps even the wider bloc. So certainly this ban from the United States is just piling on to what already is a rather dire economic situation in Europe. Tony Waterman, CGTN, Brussels.